Welcome once again. Right now at 1 Timothy chapter 5, responsibility toward other believers. Don't rebuke an older man, but exhort him as a father, the younger men as brothers, the elder women as mothers, the younger as sisters in all purity. Honor widows who are widows indeed. But if any widow has children or grandchildren, let them learn first to show piety toward their own family and to repay their parents, for this is acceptable in the sight of God. The idea is here that your parents took care of you, invested their time and their effort in caring for you when you were little. Now, when they get old, it's your responsibility to return the favor. Now she who is a widow indeed and desolate has her hope set on God and continues in petitions and prayers night and day. But she who gives herself to pleasure is dead while she lives. Also command these things that they may be without reproach. But if anyone doesn't provide for his own and especially his own household, he has denied the faith and is worse than an unbeliever. Let no one be enrolled as a widow under 60 years old, having been the wife of one man, being approved by good works, if she has brought up children, if she has been hospitable to strangers, if she has washed the saints' feet, if she has relieved the afflicted, and if she has diligently followed every good work. But refuse younger widows, for when they have grown wanton against Christ, they desire to marry, having condemnation, because they have rejected their first pledge. Besides, they also learn to be idle, going about from house to house, not only idle, but also gossips and busybodies, saying things which they ought not. I desire, therefore, that the younger widows marry, bear children, rule the household, and give no occasion to the adversary for insulting. For already some have turned away after Satan. If any man or woman who believes has widows, let them relieve them, and don't let the assembly be burdened, the assembly here speaking of the church, that they might relieve those who are widows indeed. Let the elders who rule well be counted worthy of double honor, especially those who labor in the word and in teaching. For the scripture says, and once again, Paul quotes the so-called Old Testament here to substantiate his doctrine. For the scripture says, you shall not muzzle the ox when it treads out the grain, and the laborer is worth his wages. Don't receive an accusation against an elder, except at the word of two or three witnesses. Those who sin reprove in the sight of all, that the rest also may be in fear. I command you in the sight of God and the Lord Jesus Christ and the chosen angels that you observe these things without prejudice, doing nothing by partiality. Lay hands hastily on no one. Don't be a participant in other people's sins. Keep yourself pure. Be no longer a drinker of water only, but use a little wine for your stomach's sake and your frequent infirmities. Keep in mind that in the original Greek manuscripts, the Greek word translated wine here can also be translated grape juice. Unlike English, in the original Greek, the same word is used for wine as for grape juice. So you just got to take it in context. Because in context, in this same letter to Timothy, Paul just got through telling Timothy, if you want to be a leader in the church, or if anybody wants to be a leader in the church, they shouldn't be a drinker. Some men's sins are evident, preceding them to judgment, and some also follow later. In the same way also, there are good works that are obvious, and those that are otherwise can't be hidden. Seek God while he may be found, and if you do, you will find him. Call upon him, and he will show you great and mighty things. And that, my friend, is glorious. Love you guys.